Hey there, fellow health advocates. Today. Hello?
Hey, Caroline, it's Justin. I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
Actually, I'm in the middle of...
Okay, good. So I found this amazing moisturizer on social media that's supposed to give you flawless skin. All the reviewers are saying it cleared their acne and made their skin practically shine after just 1 week. And it's on sale for a super limited time, so I don't want you to miss out.
Whoa, slow down, Justin. Flawless skin does sound nice, but hang on, have you bought it yet?
No, not yet, but I'm about to.
Hold up. Don't buy anything just yet, okay? Send me the link, I'll check it out, and get back to you in a bit. Whether it's skincare, detox treatments, stress management, you name it, there's a ton of health-related information floating around out there. Having access to all of this knowledge is pretty cool, but it also comes with some downsides, like having to figure out what's actually true. Today, we will be navigating this challenge as we explain the importance of accessing trustworthy health information, describe the steps of evaluating health resources, and apply this knowledge to building a healthier lifestyle. Let's get into it! I think most of us can relate to Justin's situation. Ever read something and decided your headache was definitely a sign of an alien virus from a sci-fi movie? Or found out that a superfood can solve literally all of your problems? Sometimes information on the internet can cause us to jump to conclusions about our health, but here's the thing. Not everything we read online is true, especially about our health. Throughout this course, we'll be covering lots of fundamental health information to help guide us and prevent common misconceptions. However, we can't possibly cover everything you might need to know to help you make your own health-related decisions. This is why it's so important to find trustworthy information that we can use to make informed decisions. Misinformation, on the other hand, is false or misleading information. If you accidentally rely on misinformation, you might not make the best choices, and when it comes to your health, that can have serious consequences. So, how can we tell the difference? While there is no single magic criteria to tell if information is trustworthy, there are some things we can look for to help us out. We'll go over 5 important clues that can give us a good idea of the information's trustworthiness. First, we need to consider the source. Where is this information coming from? Reputable medical organizations, government health agencies, and academic institutions often provide trustworthy information. That means websites with .gov, .edu, or .org are usually more reliable. But you should still take a closer look to make sure. If possible, we should also check the author's credentials. Trustworthy health information is often created by certified professionals, such as doctors, nurses, dietitians, or researchers. The author's qualifications should match the type of information given. You probably wouldn't take skincare advice from a psychologist, for example. And if their qualifications are hard to find, that's not a good sign. So, the post that Justin sent me is from an influencer. They don't have any certifications or degrees related to skincare, but they do post about this topic a lot. Based on the source, how much do you trust this information so far? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Next, we'll need to check for references and citations. Reliable health information is backed by scientific research. Look for links or references to studies that support the information provided. Large health organizations and government sites will often reference each other and departments rather than specific studies. define the studies the information is based off of, navigate to publications from the site's main page. You can often search by topic to find the studies you're looking for. With this in mind, let's look for references in the post that Justin sent me. The influencer actually mentions a study that focused on one of the lotion's active ingredients and how helpful it is for the skin. Of course, there are also a lot of other claims that aren't backed up by anything. Based on just the reference provided, how much do you trust this information? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. It's also important to check the currency or timeliness of the information by looking at the review date. Health information is continually evolving, so the date matters. More recent information is usually more reliable. Beware of older articles or pages that have not been updated recently. Generally speaking, you'll want to use sources from within the last 10 years, but more recent is even better. The social media post Justin sent me was posted just yesterday, but let's take another look at the study referenced. This study is nearly 50 years old. So based on the currency of this reference only, how much do you trust this information? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Next on our list is purpose. Arguably, this is the most important step in the process. We have to ask ourselves, is this information strictly meant to inform, or does the author potentially have another motive? If so, we have to be wary of bias. Bias is the tendency to favor an outcome or way of thinking based on personal opinions or motives, rather than facts. For example, sales representatives or influencers on social media are motivated to make the products they promote sound amazing. After all, they earn money if you buy it. So if the information you're looking at seems to be promoting a product or service, keep in mind that it is probably biased, even if it's coming from a doctor or a licensed professional. You should be especially careful of suggestions that sound too good to be true, or if they come with extreme warnings about a single product or habit. You know, those clickbaity articles with headlines like, "This pillow changed my life," or "Stop eating this one food." Health takes time and commitment to improve, and it varies from person to person, so these extreme approaches are almost always exaggerated. Credible sources will usually try to present a balanced approach without a huge bias toward or against something. Keeping this in mind, let's examine the post Justin sent me. We know the person providing this information is an influencer on social media. What do you think is the purpose of this information, and how much do you trust it? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. The last thing to consider is the accuracy of the information. See if you can cross-verify the information you found with multiple sources. And if you're still not confident, consult with a trusted adult about seeing a medical professional. Let's take a final look at the questionable social media post. For me, personally, my trust in this information so far is pretty low. Social media posts advertising a product don't necessarily inspire the most confidence. Additionally, the key reference backing up the information is extremely old, which makes me wonder why a more recent study wasn't used. So I've done some more research. Turns out that miracle ingredient is a super common one that has been used in all kinds of skincare products for a long time. The study raving about its positive effects is from a time when it was new, so it was a much bigger deal back then. And I think now we can guess why the manufacturer chose this reference instead of a more recent one. Go ahead and pause the video and write your final thoughts about the credibility of the post Justin sent me. From where I'm standing, this product might not necessarily be ineffective, but its claims are very likely overblown. I guess I better let Justin know that I'm not interested, and they probably shouldn't be either. Unfortunately, misleading or false information is extremely common on the internet, especially when it comes to health. This is all the more reason why accessing trustworthy information is such an important skill to guide us as we continue to build a healthier lifestyle. In our next lesson, we'll be developing an effective decision-making process to put all this health information to good use. Until then, I'm Caroline, and remember, prioritizing your health is a choice you make every day, and it's worth it. So keep building that healthy lifestyle, take care, and I'll see you next time. Hey.